Good morning. Oh, sorry. It's good afternoon. Sorry. Good afternoon, members. And I'll call to order the special meeting of the panel on security. Today, we would like to elect our deputy chairman, and also there are some outstanding items for discussion with you.
后呢，其实就有两位议员呢系获提名。
You might recall that after the last meeting, the there were two nominees for deputy chairman, Mr. James Toh and Ms. Eunice Yong. And at the last meeting, it was agreed that there will be an election forum for them to give their views, and their members will then proceed to vote for the deputy chairman. Now, the candidates have already stated their platforms, and also they've answered questions from members. Today, we should be dealing with them concluding remarks of the two candidates. So each candidate will have 2 minutes, and after that, we'll proceed to the vote. Ms. Eunice Yong, can you please make your concluding remarks? Now, to pick up on our discussion at last meeting, last time Ms. Claudia Mo made discriminatory remarks against me, and she said that I should not stay in the election. I find her remarks most offensive, and I think they were problematic. I've already written to the Equal Opportunities Commission already on the case. Of course, I won't bother the chairman to rule on whether her remarks were offensive. But then the EOC has stated that her remarks were most inappropriate. There's suspicion of discrimination against pregnant women, and also that her remarks might lead to denial of the rights of pregnant women in taking part in public affairs. So anyway, so that's the response from the EOC. But if I am elected, I would do my best to assist the chairman in chairing meetings of the panel on security. And of course, I already stated the point in my platform. I understand that in the coming year, there are many items for discussion on security issues, public order, public safety, and so on. So hopefully I could lead the panel to have proper discussions on all these items. And there are people who may be concerned about the police, or public order, public safety, and so on. Then the public will also be able to see what we are going to discuss. Mr. James Toh, I've been following security matters for over 2 decades. I believe I'm competent, so I ask for your support. Now, in the past few days, all of a sudden, there were cases of Hong Kong buses going to Macau. The arrangement has been made public. So all of a sudden, there could be in an innocent passage, the bus could be intercepted and people were taken away, but then they were not going on into the mainland. Now, Chairman, you've been elected. Actually, you should have called an urgent meeting this week, so we will learn about the incident, or at least we should write to the government to find out about the arrangement. And Li Ka-chu's gone to the artificial island, and he said he would want to learn about the security measures for the visit of Xi Jinping. So he wants to see if Hong Kong could help, and that's interesting. And did Hong Kong give blacklist to the mainland Public Security Bureau so they could take away people? I have no idea. So Chairman, you could have a call and meeting immediately on that if you cared. Okay, Mr. James Toh has made his concluding remarks. Now we proceed to the election. Clerk, please hand out the ballot paper. Now, this is a secret ballot, so please do not show your ballot paper to others. please just fold your ballot paper. Oh, there's no need to be two equal halves. So, candidate number one, Mr. James Toh. Candidate number two, Ms. Eunice Ho. Yong, Ms. Eunice Yong.
Hi.
Has everyone got ballot paper? Mr. Tong Yixie, have you made a mistake? Do you want to replace your ballot paper? Oh, you mean the stamp didn't work? Okay, clerk, please help Mr.
Tse.
He'd like another ballot paper.
好，係咪在座嘅每一位同事都有選票啦？
Has every member present got the ballot paper? In that case, please put a stamp against the candidate of your choice. Mr. Abraham Shack, please take your seat. Okay, I'll count to three and then we'll stop. 3, 2, 1. So we'll stop distributing ballot paper. The clerk told me 34 pieces of ballot paper were distributed. We will now end the vote and we'll be collecting the ballot paper. Clerk, all the secretariat staff, please.
Okay.
May now invite the two making the nominations to come forward to observe the counting. Mr. Lam Chak Teng and Mr. Jeffrey Lam is not here. So can I invite Dr. Elizabeth Quart, the seconder, to come forward to observe the vote counting. Okay, we've collected the ballot papers and the vote counting will start now. Number one, number two, number two, number one, number two, number two, number one, number one, number two. 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 Number one. Number two. Number one. Number two. Number one. Number two. Number two. Number two. Number one. Number two. Number one. Number one. Number one. Number two. Number one. Number two. Number two. Number two. Number two. Number two. So we've completed the vote counting. Mr. James Hu has 12 votes and Ms. Eunice Yong has 22 votes. I declare Ms. Eunice Yong elected the deputy chairman of the panel on security. Now we move on to the next item on the agenda. Well, the clerk just reminded me that the ballot paper will be destroyed under supervision later on. Next. Mr. Andrew Wang wrote to me because of his own, the reshuffling of his own duties, he would like to join the panel on security. But according to the House rules, unless he was not in Hong Kong or he was indisposed at the time of the signification of membership, his application should not be acceded to. Mr. Wang, please. Now, because of my own duties, I did not sign up for the panel on security, but as you members might know that some time ago, I proposed a bill on the Criminal Jurisdiction Amendment Bill 2019. I don't think I need to go into details. You know what it's about. When I approached the president, he suggested that I should go through the panel on security. That's why I've applied to join the panel. Is there any objection? No, then we will let Mr. Wen join the panel. Welcome. Item 3 on the agenda. Scheduled meetings for the 2019 to 20 session. Please refer to the annex. I won't read out all the dates. Usually it's the first Tuesday of each month at 2:30 p.m. That's the regular meeting. For the February regular meeting, the 4th of February, we've invited the Commission of Police to come to brief us on the crime situation in 2019. And item 4 on the agenda, items for discussion at the next meeting. The government has proposed 3 items for discussion. Well, these 3 items were included in the agenda for the July meeting. Before the summer break, but then you know something happened to the complex, that's why we couldn't do it. The first one is a proposed legislation for the offense of voyeurism and non-consensual photography of intimate parts. The second one is enhancing fire safety improvement work subsidy scheme, the financing proposal. And then the third one is installation of electric lock security system in Pek Ok prison. So we propose to take up these 3 items at the regular meeting on January. But as you know, we also have a standing item to receive the report of the Commissioner on the interception and surveillance. And some members expressed concern about the report. So I would like to have a discussion with the government later. Now, perhaps for the voyeurism offense, we could swap that with the commission, the Commission of Interception of Information Surveillance Report, because otherwise the report may have to wait too long. As for the fire safety item, well, it's a finance committee proposal, so I would propose to leave it there. You don't agree, Mr. Chairman?
Chairman, under the current social situation in Hong Kong, I think the society helps our panel to discuss the performance of the police in handling citizens' procession and protests. Whether their violence is proportional, and if someone is arrested, has exceed violence been used on them? This should be the priority of our discussion, as expected by the community. So I think an urgent meeting should be called on the 7th, an urgent session should be called on the 7th of January. The first and most important item is this topic. Actually, we have begun discussing on next year's item. According to usual practice, we are going to have a work planning committee with the Secretary for Security, as well as the Vice Chairman. So I will bring that up with him. I've heard a lot of views from the members that we should discuss on police handling of processions. I hear that Ms. Priscilla Leung and Dr. Wong, Dr. Helena Wong, you have raised your hand, and you if you have any topics that you would like to suggest, please raise your hand. Priscilla Leung, Chairman, the riot has rampaged for half a year, so I'm concerned about whether there is enough manpower in the police force, and about the private malls and venues run by public institutions like MTRs and university. What is the separation of duty? What is the separation of duty in managing the security for these places? So when there is insufficient security, the police would be called. But under what circumstances should they call the police? And has they increased staffers on their security force in the past year? I think this is something that the public is concerned. Dr. Helena Wong, Chairman, I think the LASCO and the government should put focus on what the public is most concerned about. The public is very concerned with the use of violence of the police. They're very concerned with the measures of the police on curbing the chaos and stopping the violence. We have asked numerous times about the safetiness of the water cannon vehicles and the composition of the tear gas. I think we should invite the authority to brief us on the police use of chemical weapons and endangering citizens' health. And the police has changed the guidance on using live rounds in controlling crowd. We should discuss on whether this guideline, this change in guideline is reasonable. I think we should pay a visit to Sanok Ling Detention Center, because there are a lot of questions about the place. Democratic members have written letter to the Sanok Ling Detention Center to ask for a visit, but it was rejected. So maybe, Chairman, you can help us. About the tear gas issue mentioned by Dr. Helena Wong and about the water cannon vehicle, several members from the Civic Party has sent a letter to me, and during the work planning session, I will discuss it with the Secretary for Security. I see Hu Jiwei, Mr. Wu. The original agenda item on the 7th of January meeting do not include the police violence issue. So, like Mr. James To, I do not agree if that we stick to the original agenda. I think we should discuss the police issue on the 7th of January. Otherwise, we should hold a special meeting to discuss this topic. And Chairman, please understand why this is a big issue, because the police enforcement rely a lot on its credibility. Well, in the survey, over half of the public give zero marks to the police, and the police blame it on the fake news. Well, if the police want to bring back confidence, it needs to solve the issue of credibility within itself. Otherwise, we will raise endless doubts to the police. So the authority and chairman, you should look at the issue of how the police can enforce under the low credibility given to it. Okay, Mr. Al Lockheed. Well, we still have a lot of there are still a lot of procedure to go through, but I have proposed a member's bill. So I wonder whether my proposed member bill can be discussed in the remaining term of this panel. Mr. Eunice Yong, actually, there is an item about measures for handling of riots in the outstanding items, but I think the documents involved is rather old. Members are quite concerned about measures of handling riots, particularly in the past half year. What kind of force has the police used? Tear gas and water cannon vehicles and so on? I wonder whether the Security Bureau has enough time to discuss this item in January, because after all, it is quite a big topic, so I hope the agenda can be moved forward. Okay, thank you. I hear many views about moving forward the item about police enforcement and measures on handling riots. So I will discuss it with the Secretary. And about Dr. Helena Wong's suggestion about visiting Sun Oak Lane Detention Center, so subject to members' objection, within this term, we can arrange for a visit, subject to your objections. If there is another place that you would like to visit, we can consider it as well. And about Al Lockheed's mention about his proposed member's bill. Actually, I have received another two proposed member bills suggestion for discussion. Kenneth Leung and Andrew Wan, they both have a proposed member bill on the table. So I am going to allow a discussion for the three proposed member bills in our meeting. So rest assured, Mr. Al Lockheed, I may not be able to put your proposed item for discussion very soon, but I will include it in our discussion item. And also other procedures can go on simultaneously. So I've put it down in the record. And James To and Ms. Claudia Mo. Claudia Mo, please. Just very briefly, I heard that members are very concerned about how the police would stop the riots. Well, actually, I need to make clear, make it clear that it is the alleged handling of the alleged riots. And I would also like to have two special meetings for two issues. Since June, there are a lot of suspicious suicide cases. Can we bring the authority to make clarification about the procedures involved? Well, maybe not every case, but I think clarification is due. We are all very we have a lot of questions about many cases, like the naked corpse. And now the Hong Kong Macau Zhuhai bridge. It is like an extradition bridge. People can be arrested on it. And after the arrest, we wouldn't hear news about the person being arrested for 2 or 3 days. I think this is unacceptable in a civil society. Well, if you have come in time, Ms. Mo, you would have heard Mr. James Tao had mentioned the this issue. Well, sorry, your time is up. Well, you said I am late. I was caught in a traffic jam on the way here from Lai Chi Kok Detention Center. Mr. James Tao? Well, Chairman, I think it is not about you discussing with the Secretary about the police enforcement. It's about bringing him here. The entire public is expecting us to discuss this issue in our meeting. I think we should set a time for inviting the Secretary to our meeting to discuss the topic. Thank you. I think your message is very clear.
Well, if there's nothing else, that's the end of the meeting. Thank you.